Welcome back, everyone. C Story Cop 4 with me on the casting bench or casting couch, which is actually pretty cool with three guys. We got Rickful and Nim.
With three guys.
Three guys on the casting couch. Rickful's got new clothes, so that's pretty cool.
Oh my God.
For those of you who don't know Nim, and I don't know why you wouldn't, if you're on Twitch, you probably know the guys. Basically, Radio Kappa.
I am the Radio Kappa.
We got two Nims.
I am the one to blame.
To blame? Yeah, sure. Let's put it that way. So we got Frodank, who's going to be playing against Ignite next up. So it's going to be a pretty cool game. I'm hoping so. Frodank League, he didn't seem like he could actually win yesterday. He didn't feel confident. But after
he had a really hard group. He had the hardest group.
Yeah, dude. He just casually strolled through.
Slayed it.
Yep. Hearthstone, man. Yeah. That's what's up.
That's what you do. You don't have to. He's a really good player.
He's actually
right?
He knows a lot about the game. Sometimes he just doesn't execute it the right way.
Yeah, that's all you have to do.
I don't execute it the right way either.
The thing is, you're actually pretty good when it comes to laddering, because you actually have to. You have your time, and you really take your time. But as soon as it's tournament play, you just.
And it's a very specific or a different mindset.
Yeah.
And sometimes you get uncomfortable in the tournament setting. You know, you're in the room; it's really quiet.
Yeah.
You're all alone. It's scary, man.
Oh man, that's the way you put it. I don't know if Frodan's feeling that way though. Seems pretty focused. I know he was talking with Gara yesterday about all sorts of strategies.
Look at that quiet, scary room, camera guy.
I think probably some people adapt better to the quiet room.
Turn around. Don't
really?
Look at us.
It's so uncomfortable in there.
Yeah, I know. Because there's really no sound coming in.
Yeah.
You do see reactions though. I guess if you look at the casters going crazy on the couch. But I don't know if you actually pay attention to that at all. Yeah. Anyway, so we got Frodan with a Hunter and Ignite is playing a Paladin deck, which looks to be secret. There's no reason why it wouldn't be so. And probably hybrid from Frodan with a Worgen Infiltrator and High Main.
Yeah.
Yep.
So which one would you guys say is the favorite one here?
I want to say hybrid Hunter.
Hunter.
But yeah. Right. It's usually the case.
It just... This Secret Paladin does have Belcher, though, so that helps. Usually the Hunter's pretty much about to kill you as the Pally when you're dropping Dr. Six.
Right.
So.
Yeah, especially hybrid, because if the game goes on, they can still, drag it on with the high mains, but usually they'll just face you down in the early game.
Is it quite a slow starting hand from the Paladin here?
That was just... What secret was that?
He mulliganed Competitive Spirit. I'm not sure what this is. I want to say it's Noble Sack, but I don't know. Because if it is Noble Sack, then it matters. Exactly, yeah. But I didn't catch it because the game switched a bit too fast. I'm sure Twitch chat is going to tell us.
Oh, yeah, no delay. That's cool.
Yeah.
Someone should just text Frodo and the other guy's cards. Hold on, let me get my phone.
All right, so he opts for the Worgen. He was considering the Haunted Creeper just because if it is Noble Sack, then coining out the Creeper lets you have the 1-1s afterwards,
right.
Which if you go for the 2-1, you're in trouble. However, if he curves into Minibot, then the Creeper doesn't really help too much because you end up kind of wasting it away without a juggler on the back end.
Would you attack here with the Worgen, this question?
I feel like you don't really...
That's a good question, him.
Yeah.
Thank you, man.
it's a pretty solid question.
That's all I'm gonna do. I'm gonna ask questions.
Do it, dude. That's what you do when you cast anyway.
Oh. Frodan's a next leveler. Because
Muster here doesn't punish you. If you attack with a Worgen and it turns out it's Avenged, then Muster punishes you quite a bit. So if you attack, it's gonna have to be a trade.
Frodan looks so focused. I love it.
Yeah, he's taking notes.
Okay.
I think he went into it with being a bit more chilled out about it, but now he's actually gotten this far.
The only thing he knows is that it's not Competitive Spirit.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the only... Repentance.
Yeah. So it could be Noble Sack.
Eye
for an eye, you know. It hit him back for one.
He knows it's not Redemption, probably, because there's no way Ignite would play Redemption on a board like this one, on turn one, and then follow it up with Hero Power. You would play Redemption if you curved into Minibot. So you can probably eliminate Redemption from the line of Seekers that this is.
Against a Hunter, you might...
Because
a 1-1 actually kills something.
Right.
A 1-1 actually clears things.
But it's kind of unusual, but yeah.
Yeah.
I see what you mean. Frodank. Oh, wow. His name actually is... It's Frodank.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at that.
With a big K.
They did it.
So it was Noble Sacrifice.
Well.
Okay.
Sick.
So good hold on the turn one. Turns out. And yeah. Noble Sack is the one they run two of. That and Avenge.
Yeah.
More likely.
Question is, do you Snake Trap?
Oh, yeah.
With the coin?
Oh, but then the other guy has Consecrate.
Yeah, that's the thing. And if you play the Spider, then you're less vulnerable to Snake Trap a lot.
Yeah.
A lot less.
Vulnerable. I would not
Frodan's
play the
playing
trap
like
here.
A god right now.
Yeah.
But they usually only run one Consecrate, right? He just happens to have it.
It depends, though.
This Belcher list might run too, huh?
Yeah, I was going to say, because a defensive list like this one might opt to go for... Because the four drops are really high contest.
Wow, it actually looks like the... it already is looking like the Pally's going to win because he has Belcher.
Yeah, he has
and
so
he
many
has
good
board.
Give a Shredder, though, to Froden. I think he's in a good spot. That can help quite a bit because the Consecration's just gone and now
Snake Trap
is going to do a lot of work. And you can coin out Jaime next turn, which is definitely solid.
Okay, now let's see.
The issue is that, is there even a reason for the Paladin to attack into this?
I mean, this is an important attack. If you attack face and it happens to be explosive, you lose everything.
Yeah, you lose the game. But you'd attack with a weapon first to check. Like, if you wanted to attack a minion.
Okay, right away.
Well,
I mean, usually when they Knife Juggler and Trap, it is Snake, but not always.
Well, you can just ignore this and punch face. The question is, do you play the... is there a reason to play anything but Belcher? Would you rather go for Kings
really
because it's more aggressive?
You play Belcher.
Yeah. The problem is, Unleash the Hounds then could really punish you with a coin kill command.
But you can't... Well, what can you do about it?
I think
a Shredder,
at that point,
I guess. I would play Shredder in that case.
You would?
I don't know. You what? Sorry?
You would play the Shredder here?
No, if I were to play around that exact combination, it's just kind of a very
specific don't think
one.
He can afford to play around a combination like that. Sometimes you just gotta go for, like, either it has it or it doesn't.
That's just play on curve.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's got good curves.
If he doesn't draw... Something like Unleash, he's going to coin this high main.
That probably won't do it. That's not. I mean, if you get Misha, it's an amazing spot because you get the knife hits, guaranteed. If you get Leok, it does nothing. I mean, almost nothing. And then if you get Huffer, then... I mean, you might be able to snipe a 1-1. Use the abusive.
Get the abusive
just snipe another
one.
And then kill the Belcher.
Yeah. 60% to hit a 1-1 each time.
Yeah, exactly. But the high main also gives you the Hyenas when it dies. And then the Paladin feels like he's got to trade a lot more. So the more
here we go.
60%
to hit a 1-1. This is
good.
Somewhat important knife right here. Got it.
There you
solid.
Go. Esports.
Well, yeah, 60%, I think. Does it qualify as esports?
No, I guess you're right.
So what's the threshold where esports is real?
50-50.
So what's the opposite of esports? What did you say then?
Skill sports, but usually I don't say that
you
anymore.
You know those games where you have two boom bots and they both have to hit the face for four with four minions down and it actually happens?
I think I've seen one video of you pulling it off.
Yeah.
And I remember your face. In disbelief, you said... you just started laughing for like 10 minutes straight. I remember that.
That's esports.
Yeah, that definitely is.
So what do you do here when you're Ignite?
I think you might consider playing the Coghammer just to frustrate your opponent, but if you do that, you're playing really off-curve unless you go for a Redemption play.
So Coghammer is weak to Owl.
Wow, this is such a power play.
That's really weak to Owl.
Yeah, the all-in on the no Owl is really insane here.
What do you think about just putting it on a 1-1 there?
Is it really an all-in, though?
I mean, it kind of is, because now the high main can actually die and spawn Hyenas, whereas if the Belcher was up, there's no way he goes through that.
And Ignite only runs one Consecrate, right?
That's the assumption, but it might be wrong.
Yeah, this is interesting.
I think usually you do.
So now the Abusive Sergeant with a single knife to the Belcher would actually make Frodan's life a lot easier, and now the Snake Trap is guaranteed to trigger... With the Misha up, that's actually a really important turn. Mm. Do you use the quick shot first with the high main, or I mean, that seems like to kill Belcher would be.
Then you get the two knives from the high main dying.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a lot of value, honestly. And without Consecrate, the Paladin's in a world of trouble.
Mm. All right, here we go, Knife City.
Knife City Twitch, Knife City Twitch.
Oh,
no.
But the Abusive can still do it if you just want to play it for the body.
Leprenum.
So, like, the one drop. It's just, it's going to be able to...
One out of three for an important knife here. Let's get it.
I mean, how important is it?
Oh, this game just quickly turned around.
It's just a little important, man.
I mean, it is a one attack. Oh, that's not a card you're looking for! If you play it, you need to get it with Coghammer. You can't have Redemption with Zombie Chow.
This is a Coghammer Shredder turn.
Yeah, probably. There's nothing else you can play. But the question is, do you trade the 2-2 first? And if so, do you think...
These things are going to knife down your 1-1.
Only two knives, though. Only two knives.
Yeah.
He's dead.
He's dead?
No, the 1-1's dead.
Now
we can't even Coghammer... We're going to just Coghammer the Shredder, yeah. But we could have...
You can't redeem that.
What did you guys think about Coghammer first?
I thought that was I was gonna ask, do you want to trade away the 2-2 or not? And I feel
the knife just kills the bubble on this guy anyway, so you get to make use of the bubble, having the 2-2 survive.
Yeah,
But it's I mean, you go for the 50-50.
Yeah.
So it's an iffy thing.
So you could go for the abusive first to get the extra. Maybe you keep your snake alive, right?
Doomsayer hype now.
No, if the knife hits, you use the leper gnome. Okay, so the knife didn't hit.
No, but I mean, with the like, you go for the abusive first to maybe pop the shield. Not that it matters too much. Unstable go would have been brutal. Well, that's really good position for Frodan. Now he's gonna have to decide. I mean, you probably kill this,
but
just because
the important thing is whether the other guy runs two Consecrate or one.
I mean, if he runs
I'm
two,
pretty sure he doesn't.
You can't really do much about it, right?
Yeah, no, I'm not saying he can play around it. I'm just saying that's the only way he comes back in the game.
The issue is also the Paladin is already quite low, and that freezing.
Actually, top deck Tyrion, can he come back? Yeah.
Looks, I mean, top deck Tyrion still forces you to play it a bit slowly, whereby you have to wait for turn 9 to even start attacking. Freezing Trap's going to stop you.
Yeah.
If you make a 1-1, then
I'm
you
just
have
thinking
to
of how he can win. So
I agree, yeah.
Maybe if he runs two Consecrate or top deck Tyrion.
It's going to be down to 11.
Top deck Tyrion, even though the Tyrion just standing there, keeps him from taking damage at least. And he doesn't have to.
Have you seen any kill commands yet?
No, we haven't. Not yet. There was a quick shot, but that was it. Now, mini bot.
That's not it.
This game is over.
Yeah, he's got 11 damage on board. So the only way for him to
and
win.
And Frodank takes another game. This guy's just unstoppable. He's been working out. We saw him. We saw him
maybe
downstairs.
That's the secret. Maybe that is the secret.
Dude, I'm going to start working out when I get home.
Hey,
Look at those arms. Michael. Flex, Frodank. We lost Ignite Cam because he's
just
salty right now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that victory thing. Oh, he went like this.
All right. Well, I mean, his Druid was banned. He's got to feel pretty good, though, because Hunter can replay, and Hunter's one of those decks. I feel RDU said that.
Are you tan?
Are you tan?
Why are you so tan? What? I need to be tan.
It's the half Tunisian.
We don't look the same anymore. No, I get tan fast. I just haven't been outside in a long, long time.
Man. Rickful, we were talking about a game here. Something just happened, you know?
I'm looking how good looking you are, man.
Never mind
that. Good-looking guy.
I like this conversation. You can keep it going.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Never mind the game.
So we'll just stop the series and just talk about me.
This is related. This is related because we're talking about Frodank working out.
Right. Okay.
You work out. I don't work out.
Okay.
We're trying to inspire people like myself and the chat.
Before your next game, we'll take you downstairs and we'll work out.
Oh yeah.
We'll play the Rocky theme.
Let's get huge, boys.
Yeah, we'll do it.
We get swole. I mean, Frodan yesterday, after he won the match, went straight downstairs and he started lifting. He's like, I'm so pumped right now. He was like, started lifting straight up. He was yelling.
Look at that arm. I wish they could see.
Yeah, they can't see the veins on that arm. Like, he literally just pumps a little bit before
between
games.
Yeah.
Look at that forearm.
He's challenging. Like,
I mean, you have to imagine that he probably used to be a very skinny little Asian guy. Now he's
I remember pictures of him when he was
Frodank. Yeah. He has transformed into Frodank.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not even his final form.
For his next game.
His final form is World Champion 2016.
All right. So is this Freeze Mage? It is.
He sure looks like it.
Okay.
Oh my God. Okay. So that should be a bit tougher because usually
Leper
Face Hunter is usually pretty bad.
Oh my God.
But you need to find the
high
main.
You keep the whole hand all day.
So Doomsayer is very important here.
If he doesn't keep the whole hand, he's crazy.
Oh, how about that? New card out.
Come on, Frodank.
Yeah, there's no new card for Hunter. So
Max is out?
Max is out?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Okay, this Hunter hand is crazy.
Yeah, it is actually really. I mean, the thing is, if he doesn't find the high main, he can still get pushed off the game.
You can actually. You can win instantly, dude.
This is ridiculous.
Dude, let's go. Let's go. Double Leprechaun.
That was cursed.
Double Leprechaun greetings. Please, greetings. Frodan, please. Greetings. Please.
All right.
Please.
Frodan needs to work on his BM game.
Scumbag Rexar is not showing up today.
Come on. The whole chat was spamming greetings, right?
Yeah.
But I mean, a Doomsayer, would that... that's not Doomsayer either way.
And he does get a kill with a free ping. Great. And he's still going to get curved out, though. That's the problem.
Every turn. Boom.
But do you remember Face Hunter and how weak it is against the new types of Freeze Mage, though? Because that's a really big deal, if you think about it. Because this Forgotten Torch, like, it's kind of ridiculous to say, but it's giving you a lot of removal for very, very cheap.
Mm.
And it can be used, like, as a clutch play. Oh, my God,
huffer,
this
huffer,
curve!
Huffer. Never Huffer.
Good, still though. Good, he's going to top deck the Torch. Go.
Frodan, he's so happy right now.
Top deck the Torch. He didn't top deck the Torch, but he's got like two draws out of the Loot Hoarders instead, unless he wants to ping.
Oh my God, we have Shredder now.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Are you guys seeing Frodan this?
It's ridiculous.
Everyone's on the Frodan side, right?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
But like, the thing is, I'm not on the Hunter side, but Frodan is the Hunter, so in this case, I'm going to make an exception.
Just Frodan came into this tournament as the underdog, you know, and everyone was doubting him. That's what he said.
He wasn't even supposed to play, by the way. For people who don't know, he is replacing Reynad.
Yeah, he's doing a show match.
Yeah.
So the thing is, he's got like
better. Doing better than Reynad would have.
Yeah, I was gonna say like he's carrying the team.
All right, let's go.
You made it through though, right?
Huh?
You made it through though.
Me? Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. So you're still playing later.
Oh yeah.
So he will cast you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Probably.
So too bad I made it through, man. I wanted to just poker and chill.
Yeah, I know. I know. That's why I asked Throwdown yesterday.
I would have just let myself lose, but then I looked stupid in the first match, so I had to try to win. No, really, I came here just to play poker and hang out.
Yeah, I had to spend like 20 minutes comforting Reckful after his first series because he was so.
What a nice guy.
Yeah, nice guy,
Nim.
Yeah, but there's a lot of Kepa pride going on here.
Yeah.
Noxious gradually moving away from us.
Come on,
let's go, dude.
Let's go.
I had the Reckful's feet on my lap 2 days ago.
Felt good, huh?
Yeah, it was actually really comfortable. I'd repeat the experience, but that's maybe too much Kepa pride.
Oh, hey, so Hearthstone. What's this?
No, dude, this is not, like, you don't understand. We're just watching a Hunter curve. Like, there's nothing to talk
about.
There's
nothing to say.
There is something to talk about, and that
the Freeze Mage
maybe
side.
Yeah, the Freeze Mage side is actually interesting because, like, they've got decisions to make that are very difficult. It's just that right now the options don't seem, like, too amazing. He has to play to the outs that he's got, and we don't know if he put in one or two torches. Like, there's a lot of, the extra torch, I think, is going to give him a lot of value when high main comes out, because it's one of the toughest mains to get out of the board.
I think the Bible Thumb pretty much explains Ignite's situation right now, next to his name.
Yeah, most definitely. Quick shot. All right. That's a good face. Now, you got to be worried about Blizzard if you're Froden. So you probably don't want to put anything else on this board that's going to die, so Hunt Creeper looks fine with hero power.
Yeah, there's no reason really to play any traps.
Yeah, the thing is that Blood Mage Thanos makes Blizzard hit for three, which means you lose your entire board. If you Blizzard's here, he would pop the Shredder, have the 2-1 to trade into whatever comes out of it, and the Spider would be traded into by Blood Mage afterwards.
Don't say it three times, Reckful. What are you doing?
What happens then?
You summon him.
Oh my god.
Haven't you heard Radio Kappa number 8?
And the problem is, like, if you do it and there's a loop, then you just keep getting more Amazes on the board. It's like, no! Run away. I can put in Amaz.
Prepare your exorcism, boys.
Oh my god.
Rope Hunter hype.
My question is, like, if you duplicate Amaz, does the team Archon get duplicated as well? Or is it just him? Like, literally, the one guy.
Would you want to know the answer to that question?
I absolutely would. I think we have time in this
match. It's getting hot in here.
Blizzard hype.
Let's see what's under that shredder.
Yeah.
Unstable Ghoul.
Annoyatron.
Let it be. That's terrible.
Here we go.
That's kind of what Froden was afraid of, and that's why he played the Spider. There was an upside to playing.
Oh, there's a heal bot.
Yeah, but it won't do much against Huffer. Never mind. Oh my god, this is nasty.
Wow. That was a good thing to draw on turn 6.
Yeah, Scientist, though, for Ignite is not showing up, and he's got 3 secrets in hand with nothing to do with
Froden's
them.
Froden's laughing. Curve. He can't believe this curve is heaven.
But now, if
he's
you're...
He's laughing, dude.
He's laughing at Ignite or with Ignite?
I think they both chuckled a bit.
The question is Ignite laughing or crying?
Okay. I think it's Animal Companion time, guys.
Probably both.
The question is, like, if you Animal Companion, you do have to quick shot, and then you hero power for maximum damage output. Because you have to kill the heal bot, you can't freeze trap it. Yeah, 7's good.
You also have the option to leave it up, but
Do you even care about the heal bot?
You can play Horse Rider to kill it, but the thing is, it complements the AoEs that the mage has to where he can actually wipe your board a lot more easily. So maybe that's something to consider, but maybe just smorking it.
Okay, if he has Flame Strike, he can't.
But the issue is that he's going to start having to play a secret soon.
He's going to Nova you. Dead. Yeah, I guess.
He can't just like clear the board and then
I think Froden might ignore the heal bot, but I don't. Arjun Horse Rider with Leoc into it is not bad.
Yeah, I mean, it's a ping, it dies to Flame Strike, but the
just hero power is okay.
Yeah.
But it's going to be a while. If you just hero power, it is going to be a while until you can draw with your quick shot, so maybe you use it.
The issue for Ignite right now is that he needs to develop an ice block stat.
Right, and he can't play Emperor on this board because he dies as soon as he does it, unless he's on like 9 mana to pop the block with it. So. It's rough.
Oh, baby, the decision.
Do I kill the heal bot? And he does.
Oh, my God, he killed it.
Wow.
Froden's killing it. What if he goes, like, 3-0?
He went 3-0 yesterday.
That's the freeze that the heal bot being alive would have punished somewhat. So it's like a minor
how
thing.
How would it punish?
You would have popped the high main?
Yeah, you're able to pop the high main. I mean, it's not a big deal.
But then the things under aren't frozen. You don't want to.
Yeah, the hyena.
If you hit and then.
Right, but on the following turn, you're able to.
Yeah, but you have to let yourself take the damage.
Then
you're dead almost.
Well, if you could,
the other guy would have the quick shot.
You could blizzard. Yeah, I mean, you would blizzard without popping the high main on the first turn.
Oh, you'd pop it the next turn.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's just having that extra. Froden could kill it the next turn.
Right. Sure.
Yeah.
So
you would have gone the horse rider.
Then Froden.
Well, there wasn't an immediate punish situation with that.
No.
That heal buff.
Right. Oh, that I agree. Maybe Nova was the only thing. Maybe.
Because now Froden also lost the value of cycling quick shot.
Yeah.
Playing at this early.
You're right.
Shit,
you're turning me on, baby. Cap of pride.
Yeah.
And you kissed me yesterday and I didn't return the kiss, on the cheek.
Yeah. Okay, let me explain what happened.
No, you don't need to explain anything. I know everything. Everybody here was a little tipsy and things got heated and then kisses were exchanged.
I think Sixo was probably the most drunk.
Yeah, Sixo was definitely pretty drunk.
Did you say Sixo?
I didn't say that.
Sixo was trying to challenge RDU to a
kissing contest.
Wow, no, second high, man.
A best of five in Hearthstone for $1,000 when he was wasted.
RDU, did he take it?
No.
He should have.
I mean, RDU just didn't feel like playing. He was in the mood.
Oh,
but Sixo was talking mad.
All right.
SH.
We got another giggle from Froden as he can't believe he just played a second high, man.
Yeah, but now there's a blizzard with. I mean, you could ping, but you can't blizzard Doomsayer. So unfortunately for.
God, I can't open that mince.
This is great. Yeah. Wait, how does
No, because now I still can't turn it because they're blocking. Nice, good job.
These mint physics are confusing me.
So
sugar-free spear mints.
Let me have one. Let me have one.
Sure, take it.
Okay.
Okay, good. Can I steal one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Let's just chew loudly on cam. Yeah, I don't chew mints, but Noxious does.
Yeah, I chew mints. I mean, I'll let them melt. Why not? I don't know if I'll be able to pronounce words.
Well, let's hear you chew it on cam.
Yeah?
I mean, on stream. Got it. Said cam.
Chew it on cam. Do it for me.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Chew it. Oh. All right, so next turn, though, he's getting a pretty...
This draw is important.
Yeah, very... Oh, well,
that's
damage. That's damage.
Yep. He can do six.
Not quite lethal yet.
He's going to play his whole hand.
Boom, hey, he's got five damage here.
Boom, boom.
The Leoc, so he's...
Secret needs to come up.
Oh, sorry, I should have said seven, because Leoc spaced out.
Shame on you, Rifle.
Shame on me.
I mean, what is he looking for? Nova? Again, double Doomsayer doesn't do it. I mean, Ice Barrier, Ice Block, double Doomsayer. Does that even help you? Do you even have a choice, though?
Should keep you alive, at least. But
I mean, you could technically... Like, if the Doomsayers do go off somehow, I mean, he's going, like... Let's say he goes face Hero Power, then attacks with Leoc for two, that pops it. He can't kill the two Doomsayers if you make that play.
Yeah.
He's going to be one damage off killing them, which means the only way that he's able to do that is if he top decks damage.
Yeah.
Which is very likely, granted, that gets a hunter. But you might get a trap, a scientist, something that can't attack, even a juggler. So if you can pull it off...
Seems like the only play.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, let's see.
He might just kill ping the
Abusive. And then Alex draws a follow-up.
Yeah, what are the chances of Ignite actually winning this, you think?
But Ice Barrier keeps you safe, though, right? Because that's 8 damage they have to go through, so they can't pop it unless they just go all in. So you're guaranteed to get the Doomsayers off here, unless they kill them. It's just, I don't see how you win.
No.
But.
That's.
No matter what, you're getting those Doomsayers to work. Yeah.
That's not what Froden wants to see right now.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. But.
Okay, so he can't kill both Doomsayers, so his board is dying except for he's going to have the 2/2/2s.
Yeah.
And then the mage can Alexstrasza himself, and he's
probably safe,
spot.
Definitely safe, because then he can, unless.
Then he can Ice Barrier the next turn.
Right.
Frodank, what happened?
Oh, man. Doomsayer, very powerful 2-drop in a Freeze Mage deck.
Yo, Nim, you play Freeze Mage a lot?
No, not really. I mean, I've played it, but I am by no means an expert.
Look at this.
I would usually be the aggressive person.
These
just
2-drops are going to kill all this
face.
Stuff.
Froden is trying to figure out why he can't attack face. He's like, am I a hunter?
Okay, now Alexstrasza.
We go face.
Froden's top deck is pretty important. What does he want? Quick shot?
Oh, look at that hero portrait of Frodank.
I wonder how many cards Frodank has left.
Hold on, can I get Twitch chat up on my screen here?
Sure, you should just open Google Chrome.
Oh, man.
I feel so lonely without Twitch chat. Doesn't
it's
work.
All right.
If he gets something like quick shot into anything like a horse rider, He's in a really good spot.
He has to absolutely get the extra draw. Lotha would also be pretty clutch.
Quick shot into Lotha.
That would be busted.
Yeah. Quick shot into Lothab's a win.
I think. I mean, he's only got 6 damage right now. He's looking for 9 more.
Quick
right?
shot. Never lucky.
Although there's a freezing trap, so that Alexstrasza is not going to do much for now. Right? Like, just remember that. I feel like Unleash is, this is the best Unleash you're going to get. The thing is, do you want to do this now?
Yeah, you're going to get this Stone Test Boar right here.
Hold on. How many kill commands have we seen? Have we seen any?
0.
Right, right. So maybe... Is
you
there...
keep it for the command?
Yeah. How many beasts does he even have left?
Do you think that was the worst draw in his deck?
I think that was the worst draw in his deck. Bow was obviously a ton better, even though it wasn't, like, stellar. Glaivezuka's got to be better. Maybe Scientist
was there another
was
overlap trap, or no, he only runs 2?
Scientist might have been the worst, because he gets no trap here, unless, like, he gets another freezing, but it's not going to die. But it was still, it's still a minion on the board. It won't cost you, like, 3 mana for 1-1. So I think that might have been the worst.
Bro, dang.
Yeah, he's thinking, do I get a better Unleash ever?
Just do it.
Don't let your cards be cards!
Oh!
Make them minions!
Role player alert.
Oh my god.
I can imagine that already.
So the Bible Thump next to Ignite's port or
so
name
feel,
is
are
gone
you feeling
now.
Maybe Emperor Ice Spirit?
Yeah, I feel like you're gonna be. I mean, you could go Emperor Ice Block even.
You can get the Alexstrasza back to 10 cost and play it again. With
yeah,
Emperor.
With Emperor. So you'd have to at least use that.
Emperor Ice Barrier, baby. Let's do it.
Yeah, it's definitely like the Emperor play with Ice Barrier is just so safe. Like, you can't die to spells unless he has Kill Command in hand and plays Kill Command off the top. Like, if he has double Kill Command, like,
oh,
and
you
don't play
you
Ice
could
Block.
Emperor Ice Block, actually, because then you're going to get a bigger heal out of your Alexstrasza.
Right.
Yeah.
Because that's a really big problem you're running into with the Kill Commands, like, back-to-back. Assuming this Unleash was a Kill Command and you play Emperor Ice Barrier, you're dead.
Frodink needs some good draws now.
He needs, like, the sickest draws.
Okay. Come on. Ooh, no. I actually like the block better. I decided.
What?
Well, no Emperor?
You're getting both of them.
You know what? I see what he's doing there, but
no.
That's no. That is defensive.
No,
as well.
No.
Glaivezuka.
I don't like
damage.
That one bit.
Well, it still works out, though, right?
I feel don't like it one bit, my friend.
He's still ahead. Now Frodin's got to decide, do I really want to trigger that Ice Block?
You have to.
That Ice
well,
Barrier.
You can wait for
you're
the
not,
double
you're gonna,
but
I mean...
You know that the Alex can't be replayed. Like, Frodan thinks the kill command, like, the Alex can't
guess,
be replayed.
I guess, okay, I guess you don't 100%, you don't completely have to. You top take kill command, and that guy's going to die, but you can unleash the one dog if they have a minion.
Uh-oh. So he's going to be able to take away 5 from this Ice Barrier?
I guess you don't have to, yeah.
Yeah, you could technically just pass on it.
So you have to kill command, get them to 2, hero power, proc it at 2, but then the other guy's... He's gonna have Alexstrasza by then, but he doesn't know that because there's no. He doesn't know.
He doesn't have the info that Emperor's gonna be triggering the Alex down to 10. So. I mean, I kind of like
really
the play that
the
Ignite made,
turn.
But I think, yeah, Emperor was kind of.
Emperor last
it was
turn,
functional.
I think it was just better.
Better straight
Even
up?
If they proc your block that turn, it's still better, and that's you know.
Because right now, what Ignite is thinking is
Frodan.
He's not proccing my block.
Frodan looking at his deck size, wondering where the fuck are those. Oops, sorry.
Looking
Frodan
at his
commands.
Deck size.
You can say bad words.
I can?
You just can't say the R word. It triggers people.
RNG?
Yeah.
All right.
No, not that one.
I know the Firebat couldn't say it on the stage at BlizzCon or something. But,
okay, but this is not
There's
BlizzCon.
Our Emperor.
Oh, man. That Arcane Intellect with the Emperor is pretty clutch, but you really want to kill that Hyena to
Let's
avoid
see if he would have
any shenanigans.
Kill command.
Well, now he can unleash for the kill Never. Command if he wants.
Oh.
Oh, his early draws were so good, and then...
He can always be lucky,
kind
you
of
know?
Fizzled.
Well, that's the problem I think you run into with Hunter nowadays. Like, Hybrid is obviously a lot better, but even with High Mains, like, it just didn't work. And
right, the Freeze Mage wins. Game's over.
Yeah.
I would say.
Wreckful likes to call these things, but what if Flare? maybe he didn't ban
Dude, maybe
the
he
Mage.
Runs Kazan Mystic.
Maybe he runs Flare. I mean, there's Paladin and Mage in the lineup from Ignite. You just put a Flare in that Hybrid, you're like, yeah, I'm going to cycle and wreck every single turn.
Nobody likes that 2-cost Flare, man.
I know. It was
Even good. Against Secret Pally, it's not good.
I know. You don't deal with anything. That's my
you're
problem
like,
with the card.
Like, oh, dude, I flared your
and then
5 secrets.
I have 4 mana to kill a 6-6.
I flared your 5 secrets. Guess what? It's still a 6-6 for 6.
Right. It's so bad. What? Okay, I mean that works out super well because there's no way to really get punished.
That's balls.
Yeah that's really cool.
So will the Ignite picture be changed to like a PogChamp or something?
He can pop the block, but he can't win.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Wow. Yeah. I did not expect this.
Well, it's
As soon as he drew that unleash the one turn,
it was so lucky in the start, but it evened out in the end.
That unleash turn was pretty much over for him.
Yep.
He silences the dog.
Well played.
Tired of
that's
that
not how you BM Froden.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have it up 1-1.
Yep.
Frodank. I hope he doesn't get annoyed by that because he had such a good curve and probably expected to win.
I think expecting to win with a curve like that is totally reasonable, just based on what we know from the matchup usually.
Yeah, when I see Leprenome into Knife Juggler and Animal Companion.
But I don't like, these starts are good, but against Freeze Mage, I don't think they're nearly as good as they used to be.
No.
It's really tough with Healbot and the Ice Barriers to get it done. Like, that's 24 extra health you have to go through. And that's the reason Face Hunter is so bad against Freeze Mage. Like, it just doesn't work anymore. But the hybrid is supposed to be a lot better. That's an auto win for the Warrior.
Yeah, if it's made properly. GG Froden.
Okay, so, yeah.
Yeah.
We could just show the casters the whole time.
How about we try to fix the GG button?
Wait. Why don't we even show the game? I don't understand.
I don't know.
So this is the matchup where... This is the most one-sided matchup at all of Hearthstone.
Yeah.
If you haven't played the game, and you're watching a stream for some reason.
Yeah.
The Warrior uses the hero power, and then he wins.
Yeah, the button on the right of the portrait is...
Could we get like an overlay and change that button to the GG button?
Yeah, we should.
Can we play Agario? You want to play Agario?
The Freeze Mage has a limited amount of damage except for Antonitis, but the Antonitis will always die the turn is dropped.
Yeah.
And the Warrior has
Forgotten Torch gives you a bit more damage for free, quote-unquote.
Come on. Usually the Warrior has like 30-plus health when they win at the end of the game.
Sure. But I'm just saying, that's 9 damage.
Oh, 9.
Yeah.
Nine I mean, equal 30.
It's a 3-minute Pyroblast.
Is 9 30?
Well, it's like 6 damage. Yeah.
Okay, 9 equals 30. I'm on your side.
It's 3/10, Wreckful. All
right, so assuming
it's better than 9/11.
Have you guys ever witnessed Freeze Mage win this matchup?
I have, yeah.
Yes.
I've never seen it.
I think I saw it in a tournament.
But it's impossible now because of Jessicar, but it used to be like a 10% win rate.
It used to be possible?
10% about.
Yeah, now you have a 4 armor tank up.
Well, what if it's in the bottom?
Have you ever seen it since Jessicar?
I haven't seen anybody win it since Jessicar yet.
But what if Jessicar isn't that 30th card?
The 30th card?
Yes.
Sure.
30th.
You still have 2 shield maidens, 2 shield blocks.
3.33% of the time, you won't see Jessicar, assuming you have 29 cards.
So that card counters a fireball.
All right, full.
So we're back to full health. Okay, full health. Okay. We're doing okay.
Oh, no. It's the rest of Shaman all over again.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Oh, no.
Let's just cast this from like a really hopeless feels Batman POV. We need a feels Batman on the mage.
Oh, just please. Put a Bible thumb on this.
Please right. Overlay a feels Batman on the mage.
And the GG button on the Warrior Hero Power, please.
Yeah, that would be sick. Every time you see
okay, here we go.
It.
GG. That's it.
Hit it, Noxious.
Okay,
I don't even.
Every turn.
There you go.
My god, dude.
Oh, Froden just did.
Yeah, it is the GG button. It is the GG
button. I wasn't exaggerating, stream. Yeah. I wasn't exaggerating.
Jesus. Wow, that was fast.
Oh, god. All right, so at least Ignite knew what was up, and he wanted to spare us the 30 minutes of agony.
Yeah.
It is literally agonizing when you're casting this. There's literally nothing to say.
I wanted to see the Warrior at 100 health.
Yeah. He got just a card at 5, not even like turn 8. He got another on turn 5. So the 100th health is legit, like maybe a small number even.
Okay, so
at that point,
this matchup, Druid versus Warrior, is not as Druid favored as it used to be.
Yeah, just a card again is actually changing things up.
The Druid probably usually wins. I don't know exact percents.
Well, I think it's more like 55 now as opposed to like the 65 that it used to be. Like, the Aspirant is really killing the Druid's, the ability to pressure because it's a low-value card. And even though it looks like the ramp is useful, a Fiery War Axe disables it, and then you're off-curve for, like, 4 turns. It's really terrible. So, it's the one matchup where Aspirant actually weakened your win rate for a really weird reason.
And, we're going to actually commentate this game because there's a chance for both players to win.
Yeah.
So I'll just stay silent then.
Okay.
I'll just like pop dank memes every once in a while.
Yeah.
Keep it fresh.
You're so dank, man.
Thanks.
After this poker time, huh?
Gamba. Wait, why is chat spamming 1?
Well, okay, Froden's worried. Oh, because he has his Serana starting in.
Oh, yeah. There's the GG button.
No, you can't GG button this time.
It's too late.
It's too late.
Wait, he had the opportunity to go for like a crazy turn one drill the claw. But the problem with that is that like by turn three, it's executed very often.
There's a Druid of the Claw coming down now.
And probably an Ancient of Lore coming in two turns.
But what do we
do?
With what the does Frodang do?
There's no Execute right now, so it's going to be a bit tricky. He's going to have to weapon this down and take possibly 12 damage in the process. There's a good chance that he takes about 12 damage by just killing this, right?
Feels bad.
Feels bad. Feels bad.
Wreckful.
Yeah. This is not a good start for Frodan, but here's one of the things that Ignite's got right now. You know, he's got the Innervate, he's got the BGH and the Swipe, but if his follow-up isn't something that's a min, like, if he gets a really crappy minion that doesn't go anywhere, like another Wild Growth, and never finds a follow-up, then it could really just go nowhere. Yeah, that's a bit tricky. Like, Keeper of the Grove is all right.
You could hope for, Dr. 7 top deck next turn.
Absolutely, yeah. Ancient of Lore works, Ancient of War, like, a lot of things do. Still, 12 damage off of a turn 3 play is pretty solid.
Oh, not gonna be 12, though.
Yeah, never mind.
Take it back, Noxious.
Okay, Frodank needs this Druid to not draw anything playable. So, yeah. Dead draws are...
Aspirant is kind of a dead
Force
draw.
Force of Nature.
Yeah.
Savage Roar. Swipe.
Wrath. Well, Wrath. Yeah, Wrath is a pretty dead draw.
Yeah, he can Wrath his own thing, but...
Would you in this case? I probably would again. I mean, the only thing you're going to kill is probably like a Belcher Leftover or Acolyte of Pain. So.
Yeah, you probably would. And if you draw 5 drop or less, you can Innervate it out.
Yeah.
Especially if you see the Death Spite already equipped, and it's going to kill your guy anyway.
Yeah, exactly. It's going to overkill.
It's an important draw. Very important draw.
The draw.
Dr. 7, calling it.
I didn't see it. Crap. Oh, that's good. It's a good draw.
All right, so it's not a dead draw. Oh!
No, that was a good draw. That was probably the second best draw.
Yeah, Frodan. Frodan did find something amazing, though. Frodan, like, that Lozeb is really sick.
Yep.
Really sick. The BGH is going to handle the Dr. Boom. The Swipe is going to handle the Boom Bots. So I think if it gets to Dr. Boom, Ignite is still going to be getting himself a good tempo turn. And Frodan's got to find something to play after that.
Okay.
See what we got.
If he gets Dr. 7, he can't Innervate it. Oh, that's a dead draw.
Yeah, do you just keep going face and hope you get Force of Nature? Because next turn you could go for Innervate Force of Nature and win right away, pretty much.
Yeah.
That feels like a play.
That's the plan.
I might even play BGH for tempo.
Smorking it up.
Like, I might even play BGH for tempo in this exact spot. Because with Swipe and Savage Roar, I think I would.
Well.
It's not done, so I guess we'll see whether or not that it matters or not.
Now, so would you? The weird thing here is if you melee the...
Yeah, do you go...
If you kill it with a Lotheb, then your Lotheb's going to die to the whirlwind of your axe when you kill the thing under, because you want to take less damage, but...
That's really tough.
Yeah.
Because Dr. Boom's coming up possibly next turn, right? Go ahead.
Unless you, I guess, hope for something to shield slam with 2 damage, but I guess that's not really a good strategy.
I mean, it's actually semi-viable, because for the most part, it's likely to work. Like, there's a good chance it works, but you might also want to keep that Death Spite for an Execute AoE on something big like next turn Dr. Boom.
He might actually...
We'll see.
If he's feeling really scared, he might swing face and execute it.
Actually, I like that,
but
now that you mention it. But again, the execute feels
wasted. Yeah, but then what does
he
do about Dr. Boom?
If he doesn't know there's a Dr. Boom. I mean, there's no Dr. Boom. But
there is no Dr. Boom, but he doesn't know that.
Yeah, he's going with the Shield Slam. That works too.
That's actually a lot better.
Oh yeah, that is a lot better. That's why Frodan.
Oh, that is so annoying.
That's why Frodan is dank. Okay, that stays on the board for Savage.
Force of Nature, GG.
Esport time.
Well, we don't see the card, but if it's Force of Nature, that's game over. Drew the Claw, does that finish it as well?
That's not a Force of Nature.
Swipe face, Innervate Keeper to kill the Lotheb. And then you just punch.
Yep.
I mean, I'm not sure it's the optimal play, but it looks good to me.
That's the best play.
Because the Innervatron still pesters the warrior. Like, there's nothing he can do about it. He's just going to have to swing at it and then take one more. Keeper stays up, then you can Savage Roar. You get yourself a total of 6
He's gonna
damage output.
That's the best play.
Yeah.
We're just waiting.
Wreckfall as a caster is very full of hype. That's what I like about casting with you. Do you hero power down Lotheb and play BGH for tempo, though? That might just be straight up better. Now your Savage Roar is going to be lethal, right?
Oh, I lied. You're right. BGH, you can BGH in here, power also.
Yeah. Brawl doesn't. I mean, Brawl does punish you severely.
I actually like
though.
The BJH in Hero Power.
We'll see.
It's not gonna do it.
No.
I hate when I lie. I'm sorry, stream chat.
Yeah, but you lie a lot. So.
I lied twice in this game already.
Yeah.
Oh, he didn't do it. And he does have BJH now for Dr. Seven.
So two. But so he's got. Does he have lethal?
Just killed him. What do you
can still have a lethal right here?
He would have had lethal here.
Did Froden just?
Killed, he would have killed him if he dropped BJH last time.
Did
right?
Froden just?
Oh
well,
wow!
Ignite.
That's it. GG.
GG. Boom! Boom! Boom!
Yeah, yep. GG.
Froden did the Reyna squelch right there on ignite. There we go.
Did he do it?
Yeah, he prematurely squelched ignite.
He doesn't want to hear the well plays. You know, it's kind of funny because you would think that at this point, Froden's taking it kind of easy, but it always hurts a bit. It stings.
Are you guys surprised he didn't drop BJH? Because even if the guy drops Dr. Boom...
I'm really surprised.
If the guy drops Dr. Boom, he's dead.
You win. Yeah, exactly. So I don't. There's no point to keeping BJH in
no
my
point.
Mind.
Yeah.
But there might have been a case with like Belcher stuff where you get really punished by like Belcher Bash. Like something out of this world where you just completely get blown out.
Isn't Belcher Bash 8 mana?
Didn't he have like 7?
Yeah.
So he couldn't get to 8? He was going to die anyway?
Oh, wait.
Because he had the War Axe, right? So if he plays Belcher, you still can't go through.
Oh, wait, you're saying Belcher and Bash the next turn?
Yeah, just like gain a bit of armor on the following turn. Like there's no way you're going to be able to like follow up.
Okay, so now we have Secret Pally.
Final game, right?
This is the game that determines whether or not Froda is going to be feeling
now,
safe or
do
not.
Do you keep Dr. Six with coin? I think you do.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard to say no. And it feels like the hand can only improve. But another Dr. Six would like...
I actually asked Ikup about this yesterday, and he told me to throw it away against Druid.
Interesting, because they're going to ramp too fast for you. I mean, I guess if you play the Zeus style, you are going to be a lot further ahead.
I didn't listen to the reasoning. I just threw it away and kept on playing, you know?
Okay.
Probably.
Look at this.
Good top deck.
Be nice to Wreckful, Twitch chat.
Why? Oh, why does anybody let Wreckful cast? Whoa, me! As I listen to Seed Story Cup.
This used to be a popcorn guy stream. Feels bad, man.
Yeah. I like Wreckful casting. Yeah. Just all the bad casters.
So if people don't like Wreckful, now we have two Wreckfuls casting.
I know. Oh, my God.
That's really cool, though.
Double hype.
You can't go wrong with double... Double awesome, right?
So many options. What do you guys do here?
Shredder.
Straight up?
Straight up.
Nice.
But you could aspire.
Aspire to Wild Growth. The guy just goes all in. He's just like, you know what? I want my ramp. But there's nothing to ramp up to, so. This Gog Hammer is really good, though. Oh, goodness. All right, so what's your play here? Do you go for the muster? Or do you prefer
to melee that thing for one?
Yeah, but the problem is you're opening yourself up to swipe. Whereas if you play Coghammer, you're forcing him to have another 4-drop, which may or may not be there.
Sorry, I didn't even see the Coghammer. I was reading chat. I'm doing the thing I did in the... I'm never going to read chat again. This is like Archon Team League all over again.
Sorry, man. I was playing Final Fantasy VII. Oh, where are you?
Sorry, bro. I was playing Final Fantasy. It's like, dude, I had to grind, man.
I know, man. 7-7-7. You know?
I was getting pretty deep in there.
Yeah.
Finished it all. Why would... Because, you know, the nostalgia.
Dude, I played, like, I lived on Final Fantasy IX when it came out. Like, that was my first Final Fantasy. And I literally, to this day, want to replay it. But every time I start, I'm like, if I don't, like, get really, really deep into the game right now, I'm just going to drop it. So I can see why, if you're already deep in it, you'd stick.
All right, do we keep her?
I feel like that's a good play. Looks all right, unless you just
want a power aspirant. Here we go.
Yeah, played the 2-drops. I mean, I like the keeper as well, but if you want to keep it for Tyrion or a Shredder.
Well, the keeper wasn't that good. I mean, it was the same as doing 1 damage, whether you silence or do 2 damage.
It's all the same. Oh, wow.
It's
still Shredder, right?
It's Shredder, but do you melee the other Shredder first, see what it is? Or actually, it might be a mana wraith, then you can't play your Shredder.
Yeah, that. Well, what is it, like 1%?
Feels bad.
Less than 1% nowadays, right?
But what if Doomsayer? Oh, interesting.
All right, so this thing will stay alive for the Savage Roar one day. That's the kind of thing you just don't want to kill because it feels like a waste. But there's no drawback to it. It's just that you're tanking 5 damage in it, and it might heal a lot more. And I'm sure there's going to be a turn where it will heal a minion, and that will really give Ignite a bit of a tempo swing.
Hold on.
Sure, never mind.
People are saying FF9 is better than FF7 and shit.
I think FF9 was actually, honestly, because...
I haven't played FF9.
Okay, so here's the deal. I think it is, because it goes back to the roots of, you know, the whole medieval stuff. I wasn't a big fan of the steampunk, but... Like, if you had played FF7 when it came out, it was the best game of its time. Oh, wow. What a sick dude.
He said, play.
Oh, you don't squelch that, because you know he's salty.
You almost squelched, huh? It was the reaction.
He was like, I don't know what this reaction is, but it's pretty close to a squelch. Oh, man, that's really rough, Ragnite. So Hero Power, trigger the Noble Sack, see where the Avenge goes. If it goes on, like, the Creeper, you're happy because Keeper can take care of it. But if it goes on the big minion, then, like, you're in for a treat.
In for a treat.
Rickful doesn't hear that in context like casting very often.
Okay.
Rickful too distracted by that. Oh, look at that overlay, boys.
Oh, look at that overlay.
FF7.
Oh, very good.
So I have not played a single Final Fantasy game.
The thing is, they're never final.
How old are you, NimHS?
24, Rickful.
The creator of Radio Kappa has never played.
Like, you should have played the FF10 if you're 24.
So what did you play growing up?
When I was like 15 or 10 or... When is growing up? Just all around? Like, I played World of Warcraft for way too long, but that's not that long ago.
Before WoW.
Yeah. Before WoW was your, like, sucked your life out.
Right. What did I do?
Yeah, what did you do?
Maybe you didn't play games. We were just outside getting the grills, you know?
Oh, my God.
Actually, yeah, pretty much. No. Who am I kidding?
That is absolutely nuts. I like that this challenger can actually just... Deal with everything.
You can melee the Lightwell.
Consecrate trade, yeah. I really, really like that. Because you also take away the crystal from the Aspirant for next turn. So he's not going to be able to have 8 for like...
Full clear.
Like double swipe or something.
Keep your 6-6 healthy.
Yeah. Lotheb can also lock the board down on the following turn. So that's going to give you
but
a huge...
Yeah.
Assuming you don't want to go all the...
You could do a lot here.
There's too many lines
of play.
You can also
Lotheb, right? And you Coghammer one guy, and you melee the other guy with the... Yep. And he decided with Shredder, but still melee one guy.
That's their Hero Power value. So the Lightwell Savage Roar Dream is dead.
He wants to lock him out next turn.
Shredder Shade? Or do you go... I mean, I guess he's keeping Consecration for those Shades, possibly. That's one of the things. Because it wasn't mandatory here, whereas Shade, if it comes down, if you're able to get a sweep with it...
If I'm the Druid here...
I'm feeling pretty bad.
Escape, concede.
Yeah, I'm pretty
bad. But it's a tournament, so I'm gonna stick around.
I mean, you could find another swipe of the Ancient of Lore, and if there's no Lotheb locking you out, then maybe you're able to get a crazy double swipe. But it's going to take a lot more than that to really like get you back in the game. I mean, I feel like a Wrath would also help a lot, depending on what's in that Shredder.
Actually, you never escape Concede, because you could always check for Doomsayer.
Exactly.
I just noticed the Feels Bad Man board right over here, under Ignite.
Oh, it's not on the actual hero, though.
Yeah, that was his Freeze Mage.
Oh, poor thing.
Silly warriors.
Doing warrior things.
Swipe, please. It's not a swipe.
Joe the Claw will stall maybe a little bit, but probably not enough. Belcher is
like,
so annoying.
I'm still talking about which Final Fantasy is the best.
I think the 9th was... it wasn't my favorite for sure, but obviously people have different preferences. The art style was really, really weird compared to FF7. Wow, Aldor
kings.
With kings is basically...
Look at all those big minions.
Yeah, you have to clear everything just because. Like on 6. The off chance that they can use them for trading purposes.
All right. Now, will he check for the Doomsayer before he concedes?
He has to.
Let's see if he remembers.
And what if it's there?
If it's there, then he can win.
For sure.
He couldn't have checked for it with Lotheb, though.
Do it.
The best play is to check for Doomsayer, right? If he actually drops a minion, it's a bad play.
Yeah, I mean, if you play a minion here, there's no way you win, right? Like, I can't think of a world... I mean, you could technically maybe not swipe, whereby you get, like, Drake swipe next turn, but that 2 damage AoE does nothing here. So it's like completely pointless.
Come on,
maybe you heal yourself with Ancient of Lore because
no,
you feel
man.
Ballsy.
Come on. Yeah, the guy has 18 damage on board, right?
Yeah, it's over.
You swipe for Doomsayer, please. Do it, and I want to see a Doomsayer. Come on, it'd be so awesome.
Maybe he's thinking about charging a Druid into. No, why would you do that?
I feel kind of sad though for Ignite because
sometimes it's a thing you forget a lot to check for the Doomsayer.
Is it?
I think so.
I don't know.
You
I just,
don't forget? You know,
I don't
you're
forget.
A caster, so maybe you don't.
Yeah.
It's a caster kind of move. Oh, wait. No. Don't drop a minion, dude.
Oh, no. He's going to check.
Oh.
What? Okay, so he's removing damage. Let's see if he can actually pull off a combo play. He wins next turn if he picks up Force of Nature if no Lotheb is played. That's why he's doing it. That's why he's doing it. He's thinking, no Belcher, no Lotheb. I can top deck Force of Nature
okay.
and win.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the reasoning for sure. It is sound reasoning until you look at the board and what
no,
what
it's
that
has.
Because
we know the other guy's hand is Lotheb,
exactly.
Lotheb and Belcher. He has two answers to it.
Oh. Right.
No, you're right.
It was the correct play just because he had a chance to win based on the information he had. So
yeah,
I think
yeah.
overall,
based on the information we had, the killing the
Rodan was killing it.
Wait,
Rodan
let's see.
Killing it.
Kill it now. Kill it now. Okay, now he kills it right with the shade.
Just
don't concede.
Bop it.
Kill it.
Bop it.
Kill
ignite.
It. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it.
No.
Whoa!
What? Why?
Well, that shows that he actually didn't think about maybe killing it for Doomsayer.
I guess so. But
wow.
Frodank gets another win against all odds.
You did it, man.
Oh, it's Frodank.
Yeah. Hell, Frodank.
Good job, Frodank.
Oh, my God.
Frodank,
you can cast yourself.
Check for Doomsayer under there.
Yeah, I did.
It was
check
a Doomsayer. We have inside information.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Frodank, we're going to need you to interview the winner of the match, so give him the floor.
Oh, man. Man, that first win with the Hunter versus Paladin was such a big win because if I didn't, then the Druid would line up against my Warrior last. And I just really wanted to win that one so bad. And the first game, it was like, looked like he was going to start dominating me very quickly. And then the very final ends, I think I pulled through. So that was just such a big thing.
Yep.
And Ignite is not, Ignite's like a really smart player. So he brought completely different decks for the round of 16 from the 32. And so before it, I was like preparing for Rogue. Oh, dude, GG's, man. It was really close. Then you can just
I don't know the card. I thought it was, someone told me yesterday what the card was. I haven't actually seen it. I thought it was you have to have one of everything.
No, it's remaining in your deck.
Yeah.
Oh, remaining.
So you can have
okay.
Two Frostbolts early on. You can Frostbolt one time and then, you know,
you can keep on
the Frostbolt, that kind of stuff.
So it's really cool.
So
oh,
this is where I think being a caster really helps because I've casted so many of Ignite's games before
I know
he plays Freeze Mage a lot.
Yeah.
So maybe that helped me a lot in the series.
Yeah, we thought you had that Hunter game, but that one dead draw, the Unleash turn, when you drew Unleash.
Even when dealing with the Doomsayer where I drew Snake Trap, I was like, ah, crap, this sucks.
You had like two draws that were dead against them, but you got two Hunter
early
games,
draws
so.
Were amazing. You had the perfect curve, and all your bad cards in a row.
So, Jordan, how big do you think your chances now to actually win the whole thing?
I know, come on, man. Like, everyone going crazy because, like, Frodan won a series or two, and now they're like, he's going to win the whole thing. It's like, I'm here just to kind of show that not only... I do put a lot of time into playing Hearthstone, even though I do cast. I think that's something that I'm really proud of for my work. A lot of casters in other games, they don't actually play much of the game because they're so busy doing stuff, but I always try to prioritize playing Hearthstone as much as I can. I hit Legend every season. I try to do it on two servers simultaneously, like NA and EU. I sometimes fail, though, but...
No, and
I try,
as a caster, you have to know all the information about the game, so you already knew what that new card did, like for example. And
I had
no idea. I didn't even read it yet, you know?
Yeah, that's right. And also I want to represent that, you know, Tempest Storm's not so bad at Hearthstone
sometimes. Oh, my God.
They even can help me.
Yeah.
You know, an average pleb.
We were talking with Gaara about
one series or two.
Gaara coached you, I heard.
Yeah, Gaara coached me. Saiyan also helped me a lot before the series. Gaara was actually playing his match. I want to find out what happened there. But I guess I have to play again right now, so.
Yeah.
Did we all get through?
Eloise and Caldi fell in the round of 32, but both of them got pretty close to advancing. So.
Yeah, so, well, congratulations, I guess. We're going to see you right afterwards. I think, I don't know if I'll be casting this, but somebody else might. So, guys, we'll be taking a short break before we come back. See you